Bert Rambert, free throw good. It's his first point of the game. He'll get another one.
Frank Layden looking like he's just strolling on the beach there. Nice and relaxed.
One more for Rambert. No good. Tipped out. Rambert's his guy. Left pointer. They'll go to Campbell for the jumper. Rims a hoop. Rebound. Sweat knocked it down, but he's got it. To Stockton back court. Job picked up by Wes Matthews. Works off the Averone screen. Stock front court left side. Stockton. Still with a dribble.
Wes Matthews has been known to mug a couple of people in his day.
Yeah. Stockton keeping a dribble. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Stock holds it up. Up top to Averone. 20-footer by Marcus. No good. Rebound Eaton. Back out front to Bart Kopo.
Frank Layden up saying, slow it down, guys. I would imagine we see Eddie Hughes in here pretty soon.
6 minutes left in the game. Jazz by 24. Seventh game Saturday. We'll have that one radio only for you at 1:30. Salt Lake time. Up top, Averone. Underneath Bailey. Great pass. Goaltending threat. Bailey the bucket. Pearl Bailey with 18. 94-68 Utah. Wes Matthews right side front court. Stockton with him over the right corner to Coop. Coop looks inside. Now pick right, go left, pull up, bounce it on a roll out to Rambus. He'll cross the alley, go back up top to Matthews. Baseline left to Mike Schmidt. Cross the middle with the right hook around the rim. No good. Rebound. Bailey fumbles. Picked up by Coco. Now Bart will slow it down and give the stop. 94-68 for Jazz in a laughing. Stockton left side front court. Going to be tied 3-3 with a world champion Lakers. Stockton, offensive foul. His third. Down with Wes Matthews.
Then you look back at that game Tuesday, how close the Jazz came to winning that game, and it could have ended it here. Jonah, with a performance like this.
All right, here is Wes Matthews, front court. Right side of Cooper, and we're down to 5 minutes left in the game. Straight away to Campbell. Left side of Rambus, and turn to Wes Matthews. He'll go to the corner, force one outside, shot won't go, and Bailey all alone for the rebound. Big T, the Stockton. And again, the Jazz will walk it down.
I'd like to see Stock out of there right now because, you don't even want to mention it. What if when things are a little loosey-goosey here as Matthews files Stockton, you know, an injury when this game is already put away?
Stockton will shoot two. John, by the way, has missed three in a row at the line. John Stockton. He makes this one. Stock with 13 points.
Yeah, I see some Laker fans leaving now with the Laker jackets on.
Stock hits them both. He has 14. 96-68 Utah. Right side Campbell. Out front to Coop. Now to Wes Matthews. Again to Cooper. Free throw down to Rambus. The follow away 15 footer short. Rebound tipped away. Campbell's got it underneath. Jackknife layup good. Tony Campbell.
Bart Kopo gave him a pretty good shot, too.
All right, front court. There's Stockton left side. Stockton picked up by Wes Matthews. Stockton yo-yoing wide left parallel with a free throw line. Low to Bailey. Thurl, the jump hook slipped out of his hands, but he was fouled going up. He'll shoot two. Foul Campbell.
Milt Wagner coming into the game. Milt Wagner, who actually started some games when Michael Cooper was injured and Magic was there. They had Milt Wagner start a couple of games.
So Wagner, the 6'4 guard, in for the first time in a series. And on the line, Thurl Bailey. 96-70 Utah. Bailey makes the first. Thurl with 19. Bailey 5-for-5 on the free throw line. One more. And she's good. Thurl Bailey. Thurl with 20 in the game. 98-70 Utah. Wes Matthews, front court left for the Lakers. 4 minutes left in the game. Stockton still in there with him. Left corner to go to Campbell. Back out front to Wes. He'll go right, go down the alley, shovel. Back to the play, picked up by Bailey. The midcourt to Stockton. Left side of Kopo for the layup. He misses his foul. So Kopo will shoot two. The foul to Milt Wagner.
Kopo is surprisingly quick. You know, fast, maybe more so than quick. John Stockton coming out of the game.
What a player. standing ovation for John Stockton.
And the way he has come along this year. I remember how right at the start of the year, he wasn't even a starter. 17 assists for John Stockton.
14 points. Kofo makes the free throw. His first point. One more for 100 and a 30-point lead. Bart puts it up and in. 100 to 70.
Who would have thought it, right?
Nobody. The Lakers' worst loss, 34 in a playoff game. Here's Wagner, right side of Campbell. Fake, down to the hoop. Jackknife shot won't go, rebound. They don't hit off the foul. Big Mark will shoot two.
Fouled by Sprink, I believe.
Yep. The Lakers have committed 10 fouls in this fourth quarter. Eaton had that rebound, and watch him pull her away, and Sprink got his arm tangled in there. Another great game for the big guy, Marky. Marky, don't forget, Saturday afternoon, radio only, we'll have it for you. The seventh and final game, the Lakers and the Jazz from the Forum, Saturday afternoon.
I think the crowd is shutting up boring to the Laker bench. I just assume that they don't get the Lakers terribly riled up. There's still a game to play. Mark made that free throw.
So Mark with 9 points, 31-point lead for Utah. Campbell right side of Milt Wagner. Out front to Wes Matthews, Eddie Hughes with help. Wes left side. Wes left to right. Wes down the middle. Put it up, blocked by Eaton and a foul.
Late call by Hugh Evans. John Ivoroni. No, Ivoroni held up his hand, but they're calling on Marky.
Five on the big guy. I'll get Mark out of there. You know?
Well, now they're cheering We Want Mel. Knowing Layden a little bit, that might be the worst thing to, as far as Turpin's chances are concerned, as Wes Matthews misses his first free throw.
One more for Matthews. I don't know. You ought to take him out of there, though. Why rub it in, you know? So the rebound of Eddie Hughes down court. A 31-point lead, and Eaton's still in the game. And Bailey's still in there. All right, left side, Eddie Hughes. Low to Kofo. Spin. Bank it up. Score it. Here comes Turpin. Right side, Milt Wagner. Jazz by 33. Shot no good. Rebound. Alvaroni down the left side of Kofo. He'll go to the hoop. Left to right. Whip under to Bailey. Blocked by Schreck. Picked up by Milt Wagner. Great play there by Mike Schreck.
Certainly was. That was a nice pass.
Now Court Campbell jumps one up and in from 18 out.
And Frank Layden is calling for a timeout.
That's the good news. Mark Eaton out of the lineup. We got a timeout. 2 minutes and 29 seconds left in the game. Utah 103, the Lakers 72. Reference to Jack Nicholson. The Jazz are going to be back in L.A.
Well, the Lakers are shooting only 28% in this quarter. They are shooting for the game, Hot Rod, 34%.
And this man here had a lot to do with it, Marky. All right, Turpin's in there. Scott Roth replaces Bailey. Turpin for Eaton. 103 to 72, Utah. Jazz with the ball, 2:29 left. Eddie Hughes will bring it down. All right, Eddie, straight away. Hughes right side of Bart Kofler. Bart cross court inside of Alvaroni, fought away from 15. Rebound Kirk. Put it back up, no good. He had a foul.
Five times in this decade, Los Angeles has played a sixth game of a series on the road. They have never lost until tonight.
Wagner the foul. That's the 11th foul of the quarter against the Lakers. Big Turp trying to get on the board. Now with a right hand, the first one good. Pat Riley on the bench for the Lakers, trying to think about what's going to happen Saturday afternoon in game seven. Turp gets two. 105-72 Utah.
What was the greatest loss? 34-point deficit? Was that what we had said earlier in the playoffs for the Lakers?
So it's 33 right here with 2 minutes left in the game. Right side, Campbell jumping over Rock and score it. Tony Campbell has scored 10 points. He's made six here in the fourth quarter. 105-74, shot that one over his old teammate, Scott Roth. They played together this year at Albany in the Continental League. Down the right side, Roth with the ball. Scott bounces low to Terp. Terp squares, jumping up from 10. No good. Alvarone tips it out front. It's knocked free and picked up by Wes Matthews. Wes down the middle. Go all the way to the layup for the left hand and score it. Matthews. Just close to. Front court, Eddie Hughes. 105-76 Utah. Eddie, left side angle to Mark Cofield. Low to Terp. Back up top to Eddie. He'll take a three-pointer. He got it. Eddie Hughes. 108-76 Utah. 1:10 left in the game.
I'd say Eddie's a pretty good three-point shooter. The Jazz put him in there a couple of times during the regular season.
Here's an offensive foul on Wes Matthews. Jazz ball.
I don't think I've ever seen a pro game which are two Wisconsin guys on the court at the same time.
Don't worry, Riley, you're still pretty.
Jazz ball, we got 1 minute left in the game. Eddie Hughes, front court. Eddie straight away. 108-76. You think this won't wake up the nation tomorrow? Right side to go to Mike Coco. Down low to Turp, left side. Herb has a knocked away grab by Alvarone, left side angle, cross court to Scott Roth. Roth in the paint, fought away 10 footer, in and out. Rebound, Mike Schwett. Out left, Wagner. Wagner down the middle. Right side to go to Randall. Low to Wes Matthews. Cross court underneath Campbell, lay it up, score it. Great move, Tony Campbell. Campbell with 12 points. 108-78, Utah. 25 seconds left in the game. Eddie Hughes, 18 seconds left. They're standing and cheering the Utah Jazz. Eddie left side, low to Terp. Terp in the paint, try to go up, stripped away by Campbell. Campbell down the middle. Campbell all the way, walks, got away with it, scores the layup. Campbell with 14. Right side, Eddie Hughes for a three-pointer at the buzzer. Okay. The Jazz win it, and win it big. What an incredible game by the Utah Jazz, as Pat Riley and the Lakers head for the locker room, and Mark Eaton leads the Jazz. We're going to have Game 7 Saturday afternoon in Los Angeles, California. The final score, Utah 108, the world champion Lakers 80. Back at the South Palace along with Dave Blackwell. Bobby Hansen, our Budweiser player of the game, hit 2 3-pointers tonight, and he now has 17 in the postseason play on Bobby singling the three. He had 25 points, and he'll be our guest on a postgame show.
Well, and he also played tough defense, I thought, on Magic. And to think, Rod, that at one time in our game tonight, Lakers were leading 7-2.
Jazz win at 108-80. Rod Hundley with Dave Blackwell. You gotta love it, baby, if you're a Jazz fan. They cannot play any better. And I think the momentum is there. I've said it before. If you're gonna win game six, I'd rather do it this way. I mean, if you're gonna go into the seventh game, 3-3, I'd like to go in winning game six.
And winning as big as they did, and knowing that they're going back to the form where the Jazz almost pulled out a win Tuesday night. But if people didn't see the first half, the Jazz had a streak in there in which they scored 26 of 28 points. And also, I think their place scoring 11 of the first 13 points in the third quarter was another key element.
Malone at 27, Hansen 25. Malone with 11 rebounds. Mark Eaton had 10 rebounds. John Stockton, 17 assists and 14 points. Now for the Lakers, Byron Scott at 16. Magic Johnson scoreless in the second half. Bobby Hansen held him to 10 in the game while scoring 25. He'll be our guest on the postgame show.
Well, and Jabbar had a big problem tonight also along with Magic. I'll tell you what, you know, they're going back to the form. I think now, maybe more so than any other time in the series, the Lakers might have a couple of self-doubts. They might have a couple of questions to ask for themselves.
You bet they will. So, We'll take the break now. Don't forget to stay with us. We'll be back with Bobby Hanson on the Jazz postgame show right after this timeout.
Well, the state of California didn't fall into the ocean on May 10th, as had been predicted. But probably by the next biggest surprise happened tonight is the Utah Jazz leading virtually all the way with a 26-2 run in the first half. Wiped the Los Angeles Lakers off the map, 108-80. And we're going back to California for Game 7. It'll be Saturday afternoon. One of the big heroes for the Jazz tonight, Bobby Hanson. He made 10 out of 11, including both three-point attempts. He ended up with 25 points and had a couple of steals and four rebounds. And Bobby is standing by right now with Rod Hundley.
All right, thank you, Dave. Bobby Hanson tonight, our guest on the postgame show. He had the 25 points, 2 three-pointers. You're killing him on that shot, and you held Magic to 10. Big game. Great, great game. That was the best ever the Jazz ever played.
Well, again, we're saying it's the best game in franchise history, but it probably really was. You know, we came out, we knew we had to win this game, and everybody responded. I got in a little foul trouble in the first half. They got in, and Bart came in and did a good job, but, you know, he was a one-game series now.
Yahoo. I'll tell you what. You know, as a player, I've been there in seventh game of playoffs. I'd rather go into the seventh game winning game six than losing it, I'll tell you that.
Well, yeah, it would not be a game seven if we didn't win this. But, yeah, we're going in with a lot of momentum, a lot of confidence, and, hey, anything can happen on Saturday afternoon, and I advise you to tune in your sets.
Karl Malone had 27 points and another great game for John Stockton. Stock finished with 17 assists tonight. And he had 14 points.
Yeah, he played great again. You know, Stockton's an Iron Man, and there he is over there. Give him a hand.
John Stockton, of course, was on WTBS, the superstation. He's now going to go, I don't know where he's going.
He's going to do LA TV, I guess.
All right. So back to our ball club. Mark Eaton, how about Big Mark?
Mark played great. He grabbed every rebound. He was blocking shots. I don't know how many block shots, I guess. They gave him credit for, but he changed 10 other ones that were in there. And when Magic's got me posted up down low, I'm yelling as loud as I can, Mark, get over here. And he does a great job of covering up.
I'll tell you one thing, Bobby. The Jazz have been in this state 9 years, and in sports, I don't know anything that's beat it yet. You're 3-3 with the world champion Lakers.
Yeah, that's right. And we got to give a big thank you to everybody that came out tonight and everybody at home on TV. Salt Lake has caught playoff fever, and we're going to bring you back a championship here.
Whoa! We'll be back with Bobby Hanson, our Budweiser player of the game, right after this timeout. All right, the Jazz are winner, and you got to love it, baby. They beat the Lakers here, 108-80. And our guest, Bobby Hanson, who had 25 points. Well, you're getting there setting records on those three-point shots. You're up 17 now in the playoffs. You thought you had three tonight. You only have two. You were standing on the line on the one. You came down the floor with both hands up high. The ref said, no, only a two.
Oh, well, I'll take it. But, yeah, the shot felt good tonight, and shooting it in rhythm. And I was out here early shooting, and thing just fell, you know. It was a great feeling. Everybody played wonderful, and we held them to their season low. Normally, or during the year, it was 85. We held them to 80, so we played very well, and we're looking forward to going into the Forum on Saturday and just playing as hard as we can, bring it back home.
How about the endurance, you know, the players? How about how you feel as far as playing all these minutes? Like in the last game, you and Stock went all 48 minutes. We had one game, Eaton went all but 2 seconds. Tonight, everybody put in a lot of time, but I think the adrenaline is up, and you guys are really pumped.
Yeah, you know, at this point in the season, you're probably in your best physical condition. We have no injuries. You want to be on the floor in games like this for the entire 48 minutes. And, yeah, I wasn't even tired in that game. You know, we train at this altitude at 4,500 feet. And when you go down to sea level in L.A., you know, you don't even breathe. So, hey, we're going to, like I said, we can't wait to get down there. We'd love to play it tomorrow night.
How about a gift certificate for you, Bobby? We're going to let you go celebrate. I got one of O. Stockton here. Hold on. Where have I got it?
Give this one to Magic.
There's one for you and one for John. Give that to him, will you? And congratulations, great.
I got two gift certificates, all right? For 2 3-pointers?
Yeah, all right, give that. No, you got to give that to John. Get out of here. All right, we'll be back. Dave Blackwell now have a final look at the Jazz. Victory over the Lakers, 108-80 after this timeout.
Sports fans are cheering for the Pro Image. They love the big selection of fine sports apparel from
Watt, from Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
Well, the Jazz are winning tonight, 108-80. Now the series tied at 3 apiece. Game 7, Saturday afternoon. We'll have that one on radio only for you. That'll be on national television on CBS. And we take a look at the stats, if you could see that far.
See far, can't see close, that's all. But 37.5% shooting by the Lakers as they hit 30 out of 80. The Jazz shot 47.5%, 38 out of 80. As far as the free throw, 16 out of 24 for the Lakers, 29 of 36 for the Jazz. And the rebounding, 43-41 edge to the Lakers. But the turnovers, I think the key thing, the Jazz committed only 10 turnovers.
And from the Motor City, after a commercial and a word from your local station. Office is quickly forgotten and you move on. But for these guys down here on the floor, you have a bad day and it stays on videotape forever. And then some guy who does a halftime show strings them together for a laugh. Here then are our NBA basketball bloopers.
You're just too marvelous for words. Like glorious, glamorous, in that old standby amorous. It's all too wonderful. I'll never find the words that say enough, tell enough. I mean, they just aren't swell enough. You're much too much. And just too very, very to ever be in Webster's dictionary. And so I'm borrowing a love song from the birds to tell you that you're marvelous, too marvelous for words. You're too much, and just too very, very to ever be, to ever be in Webster's dictionary. And so I'm borrowing a love song from the birds to tell you that you're marvelous.
That's what you get for sitting in the expensive seats. That was Dennis Rodman, by the way. You know, sometimes when you're out here on the road covering basketball,